Hi.
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 How's it going?
We're doing stuff that's not this.
Nope.
We're both doing it now.
Tweeting. Hey, tweeting's done.
You're tweeting. I'm going to go host.
Okay, you host the thing.
I think that's the thing we're supposed to do. I don't know, it's the thing I want to do.
Okay, I guess that's a good idea. Oh, damn it.
What?
Oh, there's nothing worse than when you
are you trying to sneeze?
Oh, you have a sneeze building and it's just about there. And then it just says, nope, not gonna happen for you. That's how I'm doing today. How are you doing today?
Well, I woke up and I got out of bed. I'm here.
Ran a comb across your head?
No, that's why I wear a hat.
Okay.
I assume it's the same reason why you shave. You just think no combs required.
You know, first of all, I did buy my first comb in like 20 years, just a couple months ago, but that was specifically for the beard.
That's different. That's hard to put a hat on.
Yeah, it is.
I guess they call that a face mask.
And definitely, definitely make sure to apply your own beard hat first before helping others with their beard hats.
It's actually better to have someone apply your beard hat. Because it's like somebody else cutting your hair. You don't cut your own hair.
Okay, good. I was gonna say it's kind of sexy, and then we went with hair cutting. And that's why I don't go to barbers anymore.
You know me, I'm a prude. I never talk about sex.
No, never once.
Not even once.
Especially not on this program, because this program is all about the rhythm, games, and the way we play them, which is with our hands and sometimes our faces and sometimes our feet.
When have we played a rhythm game with our faces?
With the VR. That's technically a face-playing game.
Oh, okay. I was picturing, like, the tablet and you bumping your nose against the thing or something, because maybe you're holding it with your hands. I forgot we've done a couple of VR stuff because we so rarely bring it in because it's such a pain to set up.
It is. But, we do that. We used our hands, and that's it. That's all we've used to play games on this show. Which I think is actually more than most of these shows here.
I mean, Adam plays games with his mind. He doesn't actually use the controller. He holds it to make you think he's using the controller, but he's not.
That's right. That's what happens when you become the Boshi, is you're able to interface directly with the computer wirelessly.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You gotta hold up those preconceptions, though. Otherwise it weirds people out. He's got the biggest brain, after all.
Oh, galaxy-sized.
Yeah.
Is there music
to this?
Let's find out. We're playing a game that I haven't played before.
I don't know anything about it.
Fischgen.
We found this on Itch.io?
Yeah, I think it might have been Andrew that suggested this game. Yep. But, Fischgen.
No. I don't know why I can't ever find... The arrows don't help. The arrows just make it look like a different thing
they
to me.
Don't make any sense. Like, you gotta hold up an arrow, and now it's... Is that right? No, I'm mirrored. Okay. No, I'm not.
You're not mirrored. You're not mirrored because we're looking over here, and if we were mirrored, then we'd be looking this... Wait. That is better. No, it's not.
This is right. See, right? Okay.
Camera angles.
I'm going to push down, because that's what we have to do. We have to play on the beat and use the arrow keys to mimic the fish's movements.
I'm going
to
turn the thing up.
Okay.
But wait until you start, in case the music's super loud. Okay, good. I'm glad I didn't turn the music all the way up.
Okay, tug back on the beat.
This isn't that Rhythm Fever game, is it, where the fish licks the hooker and makes the weird noise that I don't like, right? I can read Heather's shirt, so I'm guessing it isn't mirrored. Yeah,
Ha! We fishinged!
Are you sure you're fishing and not doing some sort of, exotic dance with the fish?
The audio tells me fishing. But I could also see erotic dance, yes.
I mean, it's just, it seems like you're dancing with the fish to convince it to come closer to you rather than actually fishing.
Fish, get! Tug the rod to hook back the fish.
What's funny is this, I'm wearing the Celeste t-shirt. Mm-hmm. I have two of these because I like the shirt a lot. Every time I go to meet Corey with coffee, I warn her if I'm wearing it or not, because she doesn't like being seen in the same stuff that I'm being seen in at the same time for some reason. And I know she also has the shirt.
That's why Corey and I don't wear the same clothes.
I can't help liking some of the same stuff that my friends like.
It's good stuff. How about you give some fishing a try?
All right, so.
So you start with the tugging the rod back to the beat.
But you're using all the arrow keys?
Yep, and then you're going in the direction that the fish is pointing based on the beat.
Okay.
Yeah? I do wish during some of the sexy dances I do, there was a robot voice saying fishing.
Call the pair of speakers and a playlist. I'm sure you can make it happen.
Just make a playlist that just repeats the word fishing for an hour and a half.
Yes. No, a 10-hour version.
Mm. Oh no, the track is just the word fishing, and then it starts again. So that'll mean a lot of playthroughs of fishing. It means during this year's most played songs list, fishing will be the number one song.
Well, it's hard doing it in the same direction. It's like too much thinking to go on.
It's a very different take on a rhythm game. Like a jackfish, maybe?
I don't know. Animal Crossing usually tells me what fish I've caught and gives me a fun pun. Unless it's Pocket Camp, but Pocket Camp's inferior, so it doesn't matter.
Sturgeon also applicable. Do you know I used to go to, Sturgeon School Division. That's how I know about the sturgeon.
I can't tell if you're lying or not.
Oh no, that's the truth. I don't think it had anything to do with fish, except for the Sturgeon River, which ran through the district. Mm. But I don't think it had any fish in it either. We never went there to go fishing, is what I'm saying. Then even then, we'd catch sturgeons, which I am led to believe aren't a very good fish. Hmm.
I know where I grew up, there was like a park where they had a man-made pond that they would put fish in. And then they would give kids some very, well, basically sticks with a string on it, let's be fair. They didn't even really have hooks. And be like, hey, let's go fishing. Look, you can see the fish and fish.
The fish.
And
so small.
And that was a lie. That was just to keep kids entertained without actually having to get new fish all the time.
Wow.
Which is fine. I don't know what I would have done if I'd actually caught a real fish.
Put it back?
I'd have to touch it.
Ooh.
I don't enjoy that part of the fishing.
Ask it to leave?
That seems rude after I caught it.
I mean, do you give it the rod?
Maybe. Let it be in control of its own destiny?
Yeah. Or the destiny of other fishes. Give a fish a fish. He'll be a fish for a day. Teach a fish to fish. He'll be a man.
I don't think if you teach a fish to fish, he turns into a man. But I don't watch the anime, so.
good fish. I haven't seen any repeat fish though, so. Yeah, the one time, I mean, not the one time, but I remember the last time I was fishing here out on the West Coast was when I was in my early 10s. And we put together some thread that we got from a button sewing kit and attached it to a tiny safety pin and tried to grab fish from in between the holes of the dock.
So I'm just curious if there's a
failure state?
Well, if it gets farther away or... It looks like it just doesn't come forward.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't see any bars or anything, so I don't think there is a failure state.
No. The fish just gets angry.
See, I told you, you're dancing with the fish. Giving on the on some of the beats though, which is nice.
I'm happy with it. The music's pretty rad too. Flapjack says no score, no failure state, just a chill game.
Yeah, it's pretty good.
Yeah, I'm into it. Back.
I was just curious, like, the one thing I like to do with rhythm games is sometimes to see what the thresholds are.
Mm-hmm. Tight tolerances.
Because some of them are like, you have to be incredibly on the beat or you're just dead. Some have forgiveness meters. Which is essentially what an HP meter is. It's a forgiveness meter. If it doesn't go all down in one go, it's a forgiveness meter.
We refer to them in Street Fighter that way now, too. Or really shields and destiny or anything like that.
Mm.
Guys, hold on. I need to sit here and recharge my forgiveness.
I mean, there are rhythm games that have a... There are rhythm games that let you play through the whole song, regardless of, like, if you've failed it or not.
Mm-hmm.
Those I kind of prefer over the ones that, like, stop you midway, because you have a better chance of learning the song more thoroughly.
Yeah, it's like practice.
I'm pretty sure, at least in the PlayStation version of that Taiko no Tatsujin game, there is a mode you can access to play specific parts of the song.
Yes.
If you want to just practice a section that's really hard on you.
I think we had that option in the Evangelion game too, if I recall.
Maybe? I can't remember.
Fishing. Constable Crab and Tiefling Aishling. I'm not sure if it's legal to catch sturgeons anymore. I don't know if it's legal to catch any fish at this point.
Yeah. That is also a thing I would not know the legality of for any fish.
Like, I know I'm not supposed to catch tuna because there aren't enough of them, but I really like to eat tuna.
Mm-hmm. I mean, is that a fishing law or is that an Ian law? Ian's not allowed to catch tuna, or I mean, no one's allowed to catch tuna.
But, I mean, nobody should be catching tuna for a while, I think, just because it really needs to recover. I'd love to get some giant tuna back out there and make tuna an inexpensive fish again. Same thing with cod. Actually, we'll add lobster too. Let's add that. In fact, let's 10-year moratorium on any fishing so we can get our fishes to be big again. This will be the second week in a row that I'll be talking about how I like to eat a dog-sized lobster.
You did that last week, yeah.
Ooh, I should move that cursor. There we go. There's an app out by the Monterey Bay people that you can look up stocks at various locations and see how they're doing. Okay, that's nice. I am Kevin the Shark. I've never eaten dog, so even if it's a lobster-sized dog, I don't think I'm inclined to. That said, a land-based crustacean as a pet wouldn't be a bad idea. Scorpion, not so much. Okay, we may have been looping songs apparently, but. Yeah. I'm okay with that. This vaporwave fish collection is. Ah.
Does this game let you put in your own music?
No.
Oh, that's too bad. I wouldn't mind throwing the Katana Zero channel track in here.
Oh, the coconut crab. Yeah, they're horrifying.
I mean, honestly, if we could put our own music in here, we'd just have to put in fish.
Yes, fish gin. That's a good question. Do you find that tweet sent to us about the end of Old School Musical, that it is a reference to Asterix and Obelix books?
I did.
Yeah, I thought
I. I can only assume it's true. I knew of those comics. I didn't read them.
Yeah, I was a big fan. This was something that one of our. You know what? I'm going to look it up because I want to give them credit because I was super happy to find that out. It actually changed the game for me a bit. Yes. Toast Brought Bomb! Brought that up. Thank you. trick, friend. So do you have a favorite fish as food?
I have a tendency to prefer tuna over salmon in terms of sashimi. I don't think about eating meat too hard because it actually grosses me out. Which is actually why I don't eat nearly as much meat.
I can tell you which fish I would consider a favorite, especially given how different they are in preparation, cooked or raw.
I don't typically tend to eat a lot of cooked fish because a lot of the time you end up with really tiny bones, and I'm not a fan of like having to dig through bones and stuff on food.
No, I agree with that. But I do prefer canned salmon to tuna.
Canned? No, still tuna.
And sardine-wise, I definitely go with the Briesling in olive oil.
Salmon's always got that gross thing you gotta pull out of it in the can.
Huh.
Or smush together or something, depending on how you like doing that.
I did finally pick up a box of, shishamo, tiny fishes from Fujiya, the local Oriental or Japanese grocery store. Yeah. I recently had them at a Korean place as dinner. They were a good $12 for a set of, I think, 6 of them or 8. A set of double of those frozen, uncooked, $3. That's why you cook your own food, kids. Good get fish. Huh.
Is this the only option in the game?
You know what? We can check for more.
Can we? He is checking every key on the keyboard. Oh, he found
the way out.
One of them.
I found one way out. Back to fishing. Okay. Cool.
I'm just gonna take us to the booth.
I think we've exhausted fishing. Let's see if there's any other. That's not the mouse.
Like, growing up in Alberta, everybody focuses on meat as part of their main dish before adding other things to it, which was never a thing I cared about doing. And then when we left Alberta, I found out other vegetables existed.
Ah, yes, that's.
Because in Alberta, only specific vegetables exist.
Yeah, you only get a few. Carrots, potatoes.
Carrots, potatoes.
Which aren't really a vegetable.
Turnips.
Yep.
And like a lot of like maybe you got cauliflower sometimes.
A little bit of broccoli.
But like the idea of avocado is just kind of like hipsters.
Or a
kohlrabi. What? Eggplant. I like eggplant.
A lot of beet in Alberta, too. There.
Yeah, beets. I liked beets. Beets were good.
I think we're done with fishing, aren't we?
I'm done with fishing.
I think we're done with fishing.
I really like fishing in video games.
Yeah.
And this isn't bad, but
there's
I kind of wish there was a little bit more to do.
There's a reason there's a side game. I have an idea.
Okay.
I'm just going to run it by you here before we suggest it to the crowd.
I thought you were about to say crab.
To the crabs, yes.
You know, the great crab that lets us know if we can play certain video games.
We did buy that game, right? There we go. It's... Go away, box.
Yeah.
Yeah, there we go.
Yeah, sure. Let's just go back with that.
Great, yes.
We never did finish it,
and
so.
Now we're going to.
Yeah.
Oops, nope, I can't do that yet. I need to...
You need to do the other thing for the controller to
yes,
work.
Yes, exactly.
I'm going to change the thing
yeah,
on the
this overlay. Isn't the joke anymore. This isn't the secret. We're just going to finish up some old school musical.
Yeah.
Because...
We weren't going to, because we were like, well, we want to move on with the games that we've said we would move on with.
And then we did.
And we did, and now that's done, so we're going to go back to...
Continue finishing this.
This, where we beat up chickens, apparently.
Yeah.
Because we're in the side content.
F1 quick game.
All right.
What would that do?
I don't know. I don't trust that the thing wouldn't... No, you have to do it from the title.
Oh, yes, that's right. So I have to go all the way
to
the end.
We double made sure that we saved. And so it should work.
There we go. Chicken Republic.
Yeah. And hopefully it will remember where we were.
It does!
Final Fantasy 4 or whatever that screen's from.
Mount Zubla.
Breath of Fire, I don't know.
I guess we get to enjoy the nice music again.
Speaking of the tune of the sea chicken, it's here now.
We came full circle. Now we'll get some of the same jokes.
Like, sometimes people miss a stream, so if we repeat a joke, they won't know.
Yeah. And then I'll talk then again about removing bones from trees and hands and chickens. Actual food bones incompatible with Wormwood gaming products. I'm gonna put that out there.
I mean, they don't use bones for their stuff, do they? I thought all their stuff was wood.
It is. You're right. It's the bones of trees.
Yeah, you know, not flesh bones.
Wow, how did I get that wrong?
I don't know. I'm not even on those streams most of the time. I do hear the beginnings and endings of every stream, though, because I have to double check to make sure they're not broken.
Oh, yeah, no, I'm... I know that good life. You get to know everyone's personal stream habits.
And then which ones to be annoyed at for repeating the same joke at the beginning of every single one of their streams. James.
I was gonna say, that can't be us, because we're very good at changing it up at the beginning of every stream.
Yeah, like this stream we were on our phones, last stream we did something else I don't really remember, and then I do remember us doing a stream where we sat in silence for fun.
We might just not be here next time.
I feel like we'd get in trouble for that one.
Oh, maybe we would be here.
Oh,
in spirit.
Oh, yeah, okay. Actually, I've been kind of hoping we could find some sort of horror rhythm game to play around the October time.
Oh yeah, that would be a good idea. Ghost Fishkin.
Good.
This is an intense song.
Yeah, I nearly died actually.
I do like that this game is very forgiving in terms of its forgiveness bar.
It's a forgiveness bar.
You get forgiveness back once you do well enough.
Like, some of these short hold notes are mean.
Yeah.
I can feel it in my upper arm.
It's like a hard press at that point.
I mean, what I should be doing is using both halves of the controller, but I'm already so caught up in doing the one side that trying to shift your brain to thinking...
Not to double.
To double. It can be detrimental.
Mm-hmm. Especially in the, right in the middle of it.
And when I was playing Hatsune Miku games for the first time, I was using just everything on the one side, and then to get better, you have to really kind of learn to use the whole controller.
Mm-hmm.
And I had to retrain myself and break habits.
This is why I've got Samba de Amigo as one of my top games for that, because it teaches you right away that you actually do need to use both sides. Because you don't have a crosshair like this. You've got two, three spaces, which are supposed to represent the upper, middle, and lower sides of your rockets.
Yeah.
But you can still play it with controllers. Things are wacky.
I like that they also make the text small too.
Yeah. Though I bet that's was probably no extra effort on their part.
Oh, absolutely not. It's probably all keyed in together.
Yeah.
But I still like it.
It looks good. Chicken outfit. Yep, the song is Marmite. I don't know if this sounds like what Marmite tastes like, but
I have disappeared notes.
Yeah, that's not cool.
I mean, compared to how I've seen them do it in other games, this is not that bad.
I really like that it doesn't happen regularly. Like, it is on a pattern, but it's not everyone.
Yeah, it's kind of on a beat. Where it comes back, which is nice. I think I'm still stuck on there's like a level mode thing you can play in IAVT. And you have to defeat certain challenges, and one of them has disappearing notes. And I'm still stuck on that one because it's a really hard song. Disappearing notes is usually not a mode I turn on. Even though it exists in a lot of games.
I don't find it as fun. Oh, this will be of interest to you. Did you hear from Beach or myself that apparently the original Rhythm Heaven was on a Naomi platform?
Oh.
Which means when we finally actually get that finished constructed, we could actually go ahead and stream arcade Rhythm Heaven.
Nice. I do like pulling out Rhythm Heaven.
Mm-hmm. Especially versions we haven't played before.
Sounds like one of those chocobo songs from Final Fantasy game. Can't remember which one. Yeah. Not this song, the song prior.
Yeah, this has a definite reference.
I mean, if you want to play a Final Fantasy rhythm game, they made two of them for the 3DS called Theat Rhythm.
Yeah.
And they're pretty good. I'd recommend just getting the second one at this point, because it's got more features and lets you use the buttons on top of the stylus, but...
Didn't we play in one of those stand rhythm games?
I know we've brought it on here. I think Corey was here.
Right.
For one of them. Because I remember her... I remember talking to her about how I've, like, not really played really any Final Fantasy.
Ah, good.
And she's like, wait, so you're listening to all the music without, like, the gut punch of why, like, it's important? Like,
yep.
It's still good music.
You are charitable.
I think somebody sent me a thing for, the Linkle mod thing I tweeted about. Where was it? Someone found, Ashiok Nightmare found a... Not an actual Linkle mod, but, one that lets you add custom characters. So I might check that one out.
To, Theater Rhythm?
Stardew Valley.
Oh!
I wanna play Stardew Valley game where I can make the character dressed up as Linkle so I can just make a chicken farm. Because that's part of her backstory in Hyrule Warriors. She takes care of Kukos. And when you fight with her in Hyrule Warriors, a bunch of chickens show up and fight with her. It's great.
Well, now I want a QTU mod for it. So I can just play his retirement.
Like, I don't even want to put in the special, like, because I know there's, like, a bunch of mods you can get for Stardew Valley that, like, put a bunch of information from, essentially, the wiki into the game. And I'm like, I don't care if I have that. I just want to aesthetically match the thing I want to do.
Oh, no, I would be 100% on board with wiki information. Like, you know what would get me into Minecraft? On-screen recipes. Without having to dig through a system. It's like, oh, I want to build. Show me the recipe on screen. Don't make me remember things.
Apparently they have that.
Okay! Well, maybe I'll have to look into that then.
I mean, Minecraft's kind of one of those games that has a bunch of mods and stuff, so I'm sure even if they don't have it quite the way you want it, mm-hmm. you can probably find
it. Able to.
I mean, a cookbook in... I really would like them to add a cookbook to Breath of the Wild. Like, it doesn't even have to be one that's, like, open or you find or anything so much as just, like, you make the thing once, it puts it in a thing. It's like, hey, this is what this makes.
Yeah.
And, you know, what would be really great is if I just want to go into the recipes and click a button so that if I have those things, I can just make it instead of this weird... Like,
yes.
I like the cooking. I think it's really cool that it's in there. Mm-hmm. But it definitely could use a few quality of life upgrades.
I was going to say, every game that has a cooking or crafting mechanic, I would love to be able to bypass and just say, I have the materials, I need to make a thing, just fucking make it for me.
Like, if you walk around in Breath of the Wild and look at, there's, like, some posters and some, like, stables and stuff that you find, and if you look at them, they're basically infographics on how to do certain recipes, mm-hmm. which is cool. Just does not help with the cooking segment.
Yeah.
I need to play more of that game. No, there is no in-game recipe list in Breath of the Wild. It should have one. It doesn't. Like, you don't need to give me Breath of the Wild VR.
Especially because apparently it's not that very good.
Well, I mean, given the screen resolution on the Switch and what it would have to do, of course it was never going to be that good. I hear it's fine.
Yeah, it's not something I'm interested in looking at, so... I don't have much to say on it.
I just want them to, like, give me a recipe book, fix that part of the UI. I don't even care, like... there's some other stuff I know that people don't like about the game, like the rain and everything. I like those aspects of the game. I agree they're annoying, but to me that's kind of part of it.
What's your stance on draw fog then?
Depends on the game.
Specifically on Breath of the Wild.
Does it have a lot of fog?
Apparently has some.
Never really noticed.
Hmm. It's one of the things I've noticed that the emulators like to take out when they increase the resolution and stuff like that.
I do know that there are people who have made like some character mods for that game, so you can play as other characters.
Nigel Thornberry.
And I wouldn't mind trying that. I just don't want to. I don't like hacking my consoles because I don't like.
Yep.
I'm totally. If anything's gonna happen, I'm going to immediately brick it by accident. That's exactly what's gonna happen. Because I don't know what I'm doing enough of the time. And so I don't like to do it on current stuff.
Fair.
But I suppose I have played most of my games on the Wii U at this point, so I could probably get a copy of that and hack it on that. Have you heard about the AI creative texture mods that are showing up?
Yes. I have been following those, and I think they're extremely cool.
I don't know what those are.
So what they've been doing is they've been using AI and machine learning to upscale texture packs for games.
Okay.
For people who use them in emulated instances where they can also up-res the models sometimes as well. And sometimes it just all it takes is up-resing the textures to make things look spectacular.
Mm.
Like, a lot of these, the ones that you'll see in the articles, end up looking better than the actual re-releases that the official companies do.
Oh, neat.
Ooh. Real instruments.
Was not expecting this kind of song. I feel like we're supposed to be on a beach rather than in a desert.
Eating cake by the ocean. That feeling has gone away with the bloobly sound.
No one wants to eat cake near a bloobly sound.
Sound? Ah, so no, you mean, sorry, you don't want the bloopity sound. I thought you were saying that there was no bloopity sound, and that would have been very odd. And I'd have to start hunting for where that particular frequency is getting pulled out of the chain.
I can hear it. It's definitely coming from the game.
Yeah, this does sound a lot like a Red Hot Chili Peppers song.
Which stand was the Red Hot?
Red Hot Chili Peppers? That was the electricity stand from the guy with the guitar.
Right.
From Diamond Is Unbreakable. Man, those were a good set of fights.
I liked Diamond Is Unbreakable. The new one's pretty good too.
Mm-hmm.
I don't dislike it. I still don't think it's my favorite though.
No, that's. I am definitely with you there. In fact, it's probably pretty low down there. I mean, when you're talking about JoJo, everything is just way up here anyway in terms of liking this. But if I had to rank them, then Vento Oreo is, it's on the lower end of things. Oh, I'm right with you there as well. Battle Tendency and Phantom Blood, I really enjoyed both of those quite a lot. Frog Blast the Ventorio.
Those are the first couple seasons, aren't they?
Yes. Yeah, Battle Tendency had the Pillar Men. It was the second season with the Ripple. And Phantom Blood is the first season.
Yeah, I think I got in on... I started watching somewhere in the Egypt arc.
Oh, wow, yeah. I think in terms...
because Beach was watching a lot of it. I don't know where he actually started, but... He was watching a bunch of it, and I was ignoring it for a while, and then, I hung out a little bit.
Beach had a very weird introduction to JoJo, given that his introduction was a compilation game with characters from all the seasons.
Well, no, before that, we tried to watch the first season,
really?
But we had a hard time with the whole dog being kicked around thing, and that kind of drove us off. So... We did initially try to go with the first one.
But then he got to spend some time with the character, beloved characters.
I mean, I do find that there are certain shows where it's just like, it's better if you do get to know the characters first, and then you go back.
Well, the nice thing about it being a generational series, it means that you can actually jump in at the beginning of any arc and have a reasonable chance of knowing what's going on. Yeah, there seems to be a lot more problematic bits with the first two arcs. Some people don't like Strondheim at all. People have a real problem with the dog issue. And the pacing, too, yes, let's be honest. But I think a lot of people, especially even in the Japanese fandom, even the first time around during the manga and then the first two OVA series, got introduced by the third part, the Egypt Stardust Crusaders. Kind of why Jotaro has become the poster boy JoJo. Hello, Sarah. Welcome to the show today.
I mean, I liked... Diamond is Unbreakable was the high school one, essentially, right?
Yep.
What I liked about that was the fact that even after they defeated most of their enemies, they became their friends.
Yes, that was kind of cool.
Like, as a trope thing, that was kind of fun to see in a show that usually just kills everyone.
I mean, not to put a damper on it, but most of the characters in the Stardust Crusaders were in high school too, technically.
Yes, but they weren't actually going to high school. I guess that's... Yeah, no, they all kind of became friends, even though some of them end up not surviving. Because they just remembered some of the ones who actually didn't survive, who I didn't like in the beginning, because they're definitely unlikable people.
Oh, Harvest.
Yeah. Like, stop trying to interact with that dude. I also just really like the fact that he technically had a whole bunch of money, but his mom found out, and so put it in a trust or something so he couldn't use it. He's like, I need extra cash. And I'm like, this is... I guess you had to do something with it, because otherwise, why would you go on this adventure of trying to make extra cash by picking up change in the street?
Well, and then you go let your grandfather use all your money to buy baby supplies, which was a great bit. Baby supplies. So that you can craft a baby.
Yeah, you know, invisible baby just went missing. Nobody seems to know why or care.
Aktung baby. Yeah, we found a bunch of chickens. They're here to help us.
Oh.
I'll help them away. Actually, you know what? Now is probably a really good time for us to take a short break.
Do you want to do...
Absolutely. Before? We should do this before.
Where were we? How? We've been online for... Okay, so probably this one.
That's the one right there. Let's start with Grim Monolith, who has been around for 60 months. Thank you for sticking with us.
Original Garwolf. Accept no substitutes for 27 months.
Thank you to the ruler of Egypt, Pharaoh Bender the 27th, who cheered with 428 bits saying bleed purple. Ah, yes, bonus 42. Here's some bits before I go abroad for the first time in 10 years. Enjoy your trip.
Tiefling Gashling, with 100 bits. Ian, I have a very important question. Did you answer this one?
No, I don't.
Do you or anyone else on Lure Fly Fish, and regardless, would you like a fly fishing kit for TTSF? Fishing game reminded me that I have a kit I can send you.
Ooh, thank you for the offer. Absolutely not. I actually have no interest in fishing, fly, or otherwise.
I have never heard anyone mention liking real-life fishing around the office.
No, that said, fly people who do make fishing flies, and as a kit, that's a really cool hobby, and you can do a lot with that, and it's, again, something I have no interest in doing myself.
I feel like it might be wasted upon us.
Yeah.
But thank you.
Really appreciate the offer.
Azure Heights... The 50 bits here, I got confused and now I'm reading this one. Come on, get in the boat, fish. Come on and get in the boat, fish.
Robo Nixon with that 100 bit cheer, a fishing rhythm game. My favorite part is when you drop the bass. Nailed it.
Fire Ace Air 1989, subscribed for 15 months, still missing that earth. Welcome back.
Freedent, with a 26 month resub, sub get and got.
I'm Kevin the Shark, has cheered with 50 bits. Don't catch me. I don't believe we caught any sharks, and still keeping sharks in your pocket in Animal Crossing's weird.
Semi chomp. Aitsu 100 with that 4 month resub. I don't know what to say before I'll just flounder around in beer for a bit.
I love it when subs get all punny. The one called Stew for 49 months. Don't resub much on Rhythm Cafe, so here we are.
Thank you so much. Dormouse subscribing for 16 months. Woot! 16 months of supporting some of my favorite people. Thank you.
Banreel with the 300 bits. Bonus bit, right, no, it's confusing because there's extra words that I'm used to. We'll be missing this due to visitors from out of town, but have a good stream.
Thank you. Hope your visitors were okay if you're watching this on the VOD. Angry Optimist, subscribing with 28 months under their belt. I've been rather sorry to miss a lot of streams lately. You folks have been hitting it out of the park. Still, I'm here for this. Most probably my favorite of the bunch. Well, thank you. We really like having you.
Max Squizzy for 26 months. Welcome back.
And big ups to E-Block for those 750 bits before. Or I forget, why are we fighting chickens again? Because they're there.
It's a side story when we went to go get the Link knockoff.
Yeah, apparently there was a lot of stuff too.
Apparently more happened, and this is the bit they cut out. Yeah. And so now we get to see it.
All right, we're going to take a short break. Don't go away, there'll be more old school musical chicken bashing after this. You were doing the forbidden thing.
I know where things cut.
I know. Oh, I hope that turns out good. Hey, that last song was Confucius Slam, which is interesting. Let's find out what the next song is. Oh, we're about to go into...
We pushed the penguin. We've all pushed the penguin.
Don't push the penguin.
No, Ian, you know we've all pushed that penguin before. Right down that hill. It slips and it slides right on its stomach. It's great.
Weed, 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 dee, 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 dee. I miss that penguin.
I'm surprised we're not fighting penguins. Get the title of the song.
That's a good point.
Okay, well, I will allow these snow chickens to be penguins. Because I have that power. Anything can be what I want it to be. And I've ruled.
You're your own Haruhi.
Ice climber chickens? Yeah, that would make sense, wouldn't it?
It's great.
Heather is powerful. I mean, the safest assumption is just to assume that I'm more powerful than you think I am, and also that I can't do what you think I can do. So yes, no.
I just found it safe to assume that you can do anything that you want. You're just not doing it for a reason that's unknown to me.
I mean, like, during that Commodore Hustle where we had the, people were calling it a wraith, and people were like, oh my goodness, Heather summoned a wraith, and I'm like, sure, but I don't know why you all assume I'm not paying it.
Yeah. You know nothing about the contract.
What do you think monster's really used for?
Sorry, monster? Is oh, befudgemonster.com! Sorry, it's 2019, Heather. I thought there was some sort of currency known as monster that I wasn't aware of. And there could
energy
be.
Drink.
Or some sort of cryptocurrency. Or a cryptocurrency-based energy drink. I don't know.
Look, we made a joke the other night about GeoCities. I think I'm allowed to make older jokes, too.
I mean, oh, right, yeah. Did you watch yesterday's Loading Radio Live?
I watched the opening.
Yep.
I watched the X-Ways to Y because I wanted to watch chat. And then I went and did other things.
Yep. Well, when we wrote the opening, yeah, we,
I'm sure the improv was hilarious.
Yes, it was. It was the only thing I did other than help write the opening with Cam. And yeah, GeoCities apparently just died in March 31st this year.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Huh. I didn't know it was still around.
I think Angel Fire is still.
What?
But Angel Fire apparently used to be a medical transcription service and web host.
Huh. And
then they stopped the medical transcription service. I don't know why.
Like I made two GeoCity sites, and I read a lot of fan fiction on them.
Yeah, I.
With the sound on the computer off, that person decided to try and put MIDIs that matched their what they were doing in their fanfic, which was neat, except they repeated and were really annoying.
As was part of the joke last night. I didn't actually do any GeoCities websites. I might have made one, but I always wanted my own domain.
I did too. There was another website that did a similar thing, except it wasn't. Some sort of like girl power pink join here and then you can put stuff up on kind of like your own website-y thing.
Mm.
And I joined that for a little while. Not for very long. It was essentially like Tumblr before Tumblr, but very pink. You know, back when, like, Pepsi.com was just a splash page.
Oh, yeah. And the Space Jam website was brand new.
And the Hubba Bubba Gum site had a thing where you could make a little room and you could put stuff in it, and that was about it. It was just like kind of like paper dolls.
For Hubba Bubba.
Yeah. I was on there a lot. I went to all kinds of company sites trying to find out which ones actually tried to make a website versus the ones who were like, well, I guess we should have something. Here's our logo on a page. You know, back when everyone was using Hotmail.
Yeah, nope. Never.
And Yahoo Messenger.
I think the only reason I had a Hotmail address was specifically to get a Microsoft account.
That sounds about right.
Now, the thing we didn't talk about yesterday in the opening that I wanted to mention to people, but I didn't have a chance to talk about, was web rings. Remember those? People would add their site to a web ring of similar things like Sailor Moon or
Robotech. Yeah, to try and get more people to to find it. Yeah.
Well, it was like a proto version of affiliation too with other groups. You don't see many shrine pages these days either. Or maybe you do, I don't go looking for shrine pages anymore, so.
Yeah, I used to do a whole bunch of Sailor Moon RPGs on Yahoo groups.
Wow.
It was where everyone did them. There were a couple forum board ones, but they were really kind of confusing the way they like to set those up. Like, they would make separate forum sections for different locations, and they wanted you to, like, go, and I was just like, that's just weird.
Stumble Upon was something we had a friend...
Oh, I remember Stumble Upon.
Yeah, I had a friend get me to join Stumble Upon. I never actually ended up using it myself.
I tried it a couple of times, I just didn't care.
My problem is...
I don't remember it.
It happened in the era of the height of RSS, so there was really... Like, it was a good service for finding stuff that you didn't know existed, but that's what RSS was for me, and because RSS was a hyper-targeted thing, I had no need or even extra time to look at things that were just stumbled upon.
Mm-hmm. And now we have Twitter, which is kind of the same.
Rockario, that's a good point, that shrine pages evolve into Facebook fan pages and then categories on fan at art fiction sites. So I guess I'll need to go onto Facebook and search my old, search for any Rini hate sites. It's been a while.
Remember, like, the days of Save Our Sailors?
Oh, yeah. I was gonna say friend, and no, they weren't a friend. I knew a person who was heavily involved in that group. To the point of writing op-eds to newspapers and being interviewed by newspapers for these.
Oh wow, I didn't know they'd gotten that much traction.
Yeah. Now remember, Sailor Moon was still a hot topic at the time.
It's true. I spent so much time in RPGs for it that that was like, anything else to do with it didn't really make sense to me.
Mm.
Like, I think I was part of about 50 different ones at once. Because some of them were fairly slow. I had a lot of free time.
Speaking of that old stuff, I managed to be contacted on Mastodon, of all places, by a high school student who was referring to, something. Linux related. Who owns their own? She rents her own Gopher site, which I think is super cool. I need to get out my old Gopher protocols or Gopher clients. poke around.
Do not think Hot Topic would sell Sailor Moon merch? Yeah, that was weird.
Oh yeah.
What's a real shame is that we don't get the nicer Sailor Moon merchandise.
Yeah. Hot Topic will sell anything that has a license. I didn't say that they have a license for.
I mean, I'm pretty sure we've all gone to Hot Topic and bought fan art that they've definitely not had licenses for.
So here's a fact. I've only been to a Hot Topic once, and that was, I think, 3 weeks ago when I was in Ottawa.
Wait, we have them in Canada?
We have at least one in Canada, and they're out on the East Coast, apparently.
I mean, I've only actually physically been in a Hot Topic when I went to San Diego the one time. When we were busy being amazed by the fact that the mall that we were in had no roof.
Oh, yeah.
It was super cool. And then we also went into the GameStop and we were horrified.
Oh wow, Lycos. I didn't know they were still operating. Lycos, Dogpile. Who was the one that I liked back in the day?
Why?
Whoa. You're just getting all the fun ones. And by fun, I mean, what the hell? Ark of the Conflave, when it rains, you go to the sheltered sections of the food court, or possibly into one of the stores? Also, it's San Diego. There's not much rain, if I recall. I'm kind of surprised we didn't have a Hot Topic in Edmonton, because apparently...
It seems like the place where one would be, like West Edmonton Mall.
Well, not necessarily West Ed. So did you know that Kingsway Garden Mall was used as a test location for a lot of stores looking to expand into Canada?
Oh.
Because...
That would make sense.
There's apparently something about the demographic of the people who went to Kingsway Garden Mall that was like a perfect representation of what the aggregate of Canada was.
I mean, when I worked there, it was heavily under construction, which was not good for our store that was already doing very badly on its own without the help of construction. So, I will believe you. I've never worked anywhere before where on a Boxing Day we basically ended up sending all of the staff home because it was so dead.
Whoa.
Like, I'm talking that Monday in the middle of summer where everybody's gone somewhere else dead.
Wow.
It was weird.
Joseph Death wants to know if it was the Horton Center in San Diego, or if you remember.
Oh, I honestly don't remember at all. This was like 2005.
Yeah, I've been recently, and I remember something like that, which may have been the Horton Center, but I can't tell for certain either.
All I remember is we found the back way in, because we were just wandering around. And there was like, I think like some sort of painting with vegetables somewhere. But it was like quite a while ago, so I don't actually remember.
Well, if it is the place I'm thinking of, that's where Corey and I went to see Black Panther this year.
I mean, it would have been fairly close to San Diego Comic-Con. Because that's why I was there. If we didn't leave very far.
Thank you.
Whoa! Mmm. I like this tune.
For some reason, Taco Bell is really popular here in Nebraska, so we get their test stuff. Oh, man. I remember moving to Edmonton, and we were, like, super tired, and the first thing we were, like, we decided to do was to go to a Taco Bell because we'd never been to one.
Oh, my gosh.
Because there wasn't one in the town that we had lived in prior.
I remember when Taco Bell first showed up in Edmonton, and I found it, like, we had Taco Time at that point.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't know about the rest of the world, but at least in Alberta, Taco Time's, like, really not considered to be good food.
It's not great.
Like, it was one of those franchises where you always knew that it was always owner-run. And
yeah.
Owners never cared about the restaurant.
Yeah. I mean, it's not, like, the worst food option you can make. At least
No. Not
that I remember, but... But it's not like the choice you would probably... They had one in a food court where I grew up, and I liked to go there because I liked it over a lot of the other places in the food court.
But I remember the food tasted almost nothing like even anything you'd consider Mexican.
Yeah.
And it was always this weird... It wasn't crispy. It was just overcooked and kind of hard. So eating Taco Bell for the first time was a revelation. Hi!
Hello, game.
That's some good throbbing you got going on there.
A little weird.
Can you let me... Uh-huh. Okay, cool.
Cool.
Yeah, Taco Bell is trash. But it's top tier trash, in my opinion.
Oh, and when Grand Prairie got its first like sushi place.
Oh.
We start going there, but later, after that, our food court got one.
Oh.
And they did not have stainless steel counters.
Oh.
They actually like it was not the best. It was not where you really should go.
Mm-hmm.
But it was okay. It didn't taste wrong.
It's something special.
It was a weird time. There was also that fusion restaurant that came out that needed to go away and did eventually. We went there because they were like, oh yeah, Asian fusion, whatever. And it's like, all right. Have you ever tried to drink miso soup out of a square bowl?
Why would you do
or
that?
Or have tempura done where they basically just do the whole vegetable at once for some reason? Yeah. As far as I was concerned, this wasn't fusion. This was not food.
No, yeah. What are they fusing it with?
And they still give you chopsticks, so... I don't know how you're really supposed to eat it.
That's how you know it's Asian. Oh, I was just thinking... You know what I haven't had in years? And I mean, wow, that's a gas mask chicken. That's weird.
Survivalist chicken.
Well, and by years, I mean, I think actually decades at this point, is an Orange Julius. And I know we have one in town, at least.
We've got one out in Langford.
I think I remember seeing one in,
another one actually in town yet?
Yeah, at the mall that's not Hillside and not downtown.
No, we don't have an Orange Julius at Maple. Oh, no, wait, we do. It's in that weird kiosk.
Yeah, which is where I find most Orange Juliuses to be.
Mayfair. I was going to say no because the one I remember is the bubble tea place. I'm not a fan of this.
Yeah, bubble tea is definitely the Orange Julius of the 2000s.
They make
of the new millennium.
If you go there, I think it's called something like Big Orange or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
They make bubble tea with ice cream. It's actually pretty good.
That actually does sound quite good.
I worked in Mayfair for a little bit, so we on days where that were slow, sometimes we would take turns just going to the food court and getting stuff. And summertime, ice cream bubble tea was a fun one to go for.
It's a lot of thickness in your drink there.
I mean, I wouldn't get it with the tapioca balls.
Okay.
With the ice cream, just because that's a bit much. Or at least I found it to be a bit much.
I just need to find a way now of convincing people that, you know, espresso with tapioca balls is somehow a delicacy. This is intense. Tryptophan Dragon Ball is a great name for a boba tea place. And if it weren't, you know, such a bait for a lawsuit, I would say that The Mandalorian would be a great name for a bubble tea place as well.
I know I saw a comic for Avatar that showed,
Uncle Iroh?
Yeah.
Yeah, inventing bubble tea?
Yeah. I love that character. He's so good. He's like one of the best characters.
If I recall, didn't the voice actor die just before?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's right. He died just before they did a flashback in Korra.
Still really good character.
Yep.
I started actually following Film Critic Hulk, and just in time to watch him play Pokemon for the first time.
Oh no!
And to do Avatar: The Last Airbender for the first time. Ooh.
I need to find a way of getting Yakuza 0 into his face then. The reason for that being, now that I give it a bit more thought, is the more that I think about it, Yakuza 0 is actually just the perfect prequel, because it's one of those few prequels that gives the lens story to the games that come after it chronologically, but not in a way that is checking off boxes the way the Star Wars prequels did. It's not there to fill in all the holes of, I wonder what this was like back in the past. It's like, no, this is just a story about these two people. And really makes you love the people, and then also really gives you information as to why the people are the way they are in the later games. Your character development and storytelling. I'm Kevin the Shark. I don't think you're alone in not being fond of the Last Airbender film. It's, at least as far as I understand, widely considered to be a very bad adaptation of the Airbender story.
Yes, it is. I've watched it. I watched it with a friend who had not seen any Airbender, and they also agreed that it was a terrible movie, just on its own.
Yeah.
It was not good, is not recommended. Go watch the cartoon. The cartoon is amazing.
Yeah. Silent Optimist, Red Dead Redemption 2 is pretty good in that regard. Like, do you mean as a sequel, or am I just playing Red Dead Redemption 2 wrong and it's supposed to be a prequel? Because I've kind of been, I kind of don't know where it fits, and I don't feel like I need to know, but...
I didn't think it was one of those games that had any connection, necessarily, to...
Well, the characters are always...
Apparently it's a prequel.
Okay, which is odd, because it feels to me like a sequel, because everyone's always talking about the things that the people in the game did before the game started.
Mm.
because I didn't play the original at all.
What I liked about the Avatar movie, not the Airbender one, but the other one, is that when I went to watch it, it cut out during the battle scenes, and it did it twice, to the point where we'd seen enough of the story to know what was going on, but not enough to quite finish the movie, and they gave everybody in the theater 2 free movie tickets. So I got really good value out of that movie.
Nice. Means you didn't have to watch all of Avatar, and you got to see 2 different movies.
Yeah.
So I'm taking it that you didn't own a truck with Avatar characters and the logo painted on it all over, did you?
Nope.
Because I know that truck exists in Edmonton. Some people really got into the Avatar fandom. And if you're one of those people in the chat, I don't want to yuck your yum, but I did not.
Yeah. It was... Yeah?
Yeah.
Like I don't think there was anything particularly bad about the movie.
But there's nothing particularly great
there's
either.
There's nothing that hooked me. There were definitely certain characters who I thought were just dumb.
Oh, yeah.
But... It exists. If you like it, then great. I mean, for the most part, a lot of media, even media I don't like, I'm of the opinion of if somebody likes it, then awesome. Unless I think it's harmful in some way. Then I have some different feelings about it.
I feel like a live-action Avatar The Last Airbender could be good, but it's going to have to be handled very well.
Right, that whole... I see.
Sorry?
It's just... Catching up on something in chat where someone tried to make a joke about, but is Avatar an anime? And they got taken seriously. Avatar definitely comes from that period where there's an anime style going on, but a lot of animated stuff, even stuff that is animated within North America, also gets animated in Japan.
Yeah, or Korea and, specifically.
Yeah, or there's also a lot of stuff that we call anime that was animated in Korea. Mm-hmm.
I mean, like, if you want to talk about where something was animated, then, like, yes, technically The Simpsons counts as anime, so... I prefer to use the phrase anime-inspired, because that, to me, gets closer to what's actually going on. That you've got directors and character designers in North America who were inspired by anime.
Yeah, you can see it in a lot of stuff now.
Yeah. And, like, that doesn't mean that it's anime, but it means that where people draw inspiration from is part of film criticism. Oh, Jesus Christ!
What the heck? I was not ready for the split screen. I don't like it.
Like, one of the easiest ways to start getting into film criticism through influence and tracking trends and whatnot is, in my opinion, Star Wars. Seeing where George Lucas got his inspirations from, and then seeing how those go out to the rest of the film world. And other directors also having, you know, drawing influence and inspiration from Japanese movie directors. Like the way that Star Wars itself is basically a remake of The Hidden Fortress. And does that make it a Japanese film? No, it makes it a Japanese-inspired film.
I mean, my understanding of the term anime, as a term, is that it is basically a shortened French word for animation.
Mm-hmm.
And they use it in Japan. The end. like they make animation.
Mm-hmm.
We use it as a weird subtype of animation to try and denote a style because it's different from the style we've seen before.
Mm-hmm.
And to me, that's just odd.
Yeah, we can all have our own definitions. I've made mine very well known as well. But after last Desert Bus, when it came up and became a meme.
I mean, I remember when a lot of North American cartoons were taking on that kind of style, where they would make the eyes bigger and they would do whatever. It still didn't quite have the same drawing style.
Yeah.
But they were doing it to things like Archie and other properties, because it seemed like the hot thing. And that's just something that happens in
a lot of
stuff. But then it sprung up those arguments of like, oh, well, that's not real anime and this isn't whatever. And it's just like, okay. The only reason I don't like the classification of like, oh, is that an anime or not, is there are some people who are like, well, I won't watch it because it's anime, in the same way that some people won't watch something because it's animated.
Or I won't watch something because it's not anime.
And to me, that's just odd, because then you get people who think it's a genre when it's not. And it's like, oh, well, I like all anime. And I'm like, no, you don't. You don't. Trust me. You don't.
No, no one does.
That's like saying you like all movies. You don't. You might have more affinity for what tends to go in there, in like an aesthetic or a thing like that. Sure, I'll give you that, but I don't know. It weirds me out.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, trying to define things based on where a word comes from too. Getting back to Sarah saying that apparently. A thing we do in English, though, we take the generic word from another language uses, and use it to refer to a specific type of thing, like chai tea. And this is, like, for those of you, it's early Japanese language.
I should turn all these off.
Yeah, they're pretty amazing. Like, the Japanese language has a specific alphabet just for loan words. The katakana alphabet.
Mm.
So, like, anime is written in katakana because it is a loan word from French for animation. Other ones would be kohi, which is just them fitting the word coffee into that syllabized alphabet.
Oh, zombie chicken.
Or punku, for punk music.
Goodness. The amount of fanfics I used to read where, so like, it's an example of it. Tokyo Mew Mew has a character named Mint, but they call her Minto when they say her name.
And now, who calls her Minto? Is it the
other characters, because like that's how they pronounce her name, but her name is just Mint.
Mm-hmm.
And the amount of fanfics that I've read where everyone keeps calling her Minto.
Yeah.
And I'm like, that's not actually.
Well, I mean, technically, her name is Minto, depending on how it's originally written. Does it mean that it's supposed to be? Does it mean that when you're writing it out in English, you should write Mint or Minto? And this is where I come into the question of. Transliteration and translation.
Well, no, her name written out is Mint.
Like, do they use the Romaji?
Yes.
Okay, yeah, then in that case, yeah, then her name would be Mint.
It's just people trying to make the pronunciation happen in things, and it weirds me out, because I'm just like, okay.
Oh yeah, Sarah is bringing up the classic one from Death Note, Raito versus Light.
Oh, right. Yeah. Is it Lupin? Lupin?
Lupin, Rupan, Wolf.
Oh, right, I forgot about the Wolf one.
Yeah, that's when I can speak more directly to Wurtz because.
Nope.
The character of Lupin is Lupin with an L, because that's how the character spells his name, with Roman characters, L-U-P-I-N.
Well, I mean, he's the third of the original, which is an actual character in French, which also...
So, despite the fact that all of the characters who are portrayed by Japanese people pronounce it Lupin, that's because that's how you would say his name as a Japanese person. Translated into Japanese katakana. True to fame, no, I'm not fluent. I'm not fluent in Japanese. I don't even think I'm fluent in English, to be honest.
Tell you something though, I don't like the effects on this game anymore.
They're just getting real difficult.
It's not the difficulty that they present, it's the constant, like, feeling of hitting to the edge of nausea. Like, this here, fine. With the whatever, but the twisting of the screen while it's coming towards you
is a bit much.
With flashing colors, that's a lot. that's just a lot.
Yeah, I want to jump into there before people get that upset with someone. Chaos Trader, there's no L in Japanese, correct? More like the sound for it. There's no L, there's no R. There is an in-between sound that is uniquely Japanese.
Yeah, and it sounds kind of like either one to us.
What is this?
It looks like, some sort of sewer level.
I meant the face guy.
The face mask chicken?
Yeah, well, there's the mode for this version. Oh, there it is!
Oh!
Okay, best mode!
Okay. That's fine.
Beach mode is back. I love video games! I'm trying to look through him. Like, I wish there was a bit more going on in the song so that we weren't so captivated by this man.
I'm glad he changes it up every now and then.
Mm-hmm. Well, I think this is the programmer is doing, and they really put some thought into this mode.
This feels like someone did this as a goof, and they kept it in.
You're killing me, dude! Literally killing me!
Doesn't he come up with the Game Over screen too?
Yes, yeah. He does! Hey, big brother. Your turn.
Potatoes! Wait, I gotta pay attention to the game.
300 potatoes. The guy looks a lot like Jeff, a schlubbier Jeff Thu, which is weird to me. mean, he's got some really good hige on his pants too, though. Gotta admit. You seem to be doing well. Fairbender, no, this person does not look like someone who's drawn the short straw. This is someone who is into it, and I respect that. Track my schleppy statement. Anyone who's willing to do this amount of dancing with this amount of heart. They know what they're doing. And they're rocking it. Yeah, committing to the bit. If they did regret it, they're the dev. They can patch this out.
Yeah, I don't know why there's an assumption going on that this person didn't want this in here.
No, I've done...
Have you seen some of the things we've done on live?
Yes.
We don't regret those.
Last night. Angry Optimist, yeah, you're right. I wouldn't regret this. This is the sort of thing that gets you into Valhalla.
Okay, so the thing with the eye drops.
Oh, yeah.
Seriously?
Wait, what?
I mean, there's a bunch of chickens here. That's a little distracting. But the thing with the eye drops literally happened a week or 2 weeks ago, not on camera. And then they chose to do it again.
Yep, because we knew it would be good content.
They already knew what this would be like. We already tested it, not even like purposefully.
Acting.
Beach has been putting those eye drops in his eyes since he got back from PAX. And around the office, someone asked about them and he was like, you wanna try them? And then before you knew it, everybody in the office was like, yeah, me too.
Oh yeah, there's like six of us here in the kitchen just putting stuff in our eyes.
Even people who you didn't see on camera last night doing it.
Yeah.
Because I know Corey did it too. And
Adam.
Kathleen and Adam and... I think Corey even tweeted about it that sometimes... She wrote a tweet that was like, sometimes the team building exercise is putting eye drops in your eyes.
Yep. I was like, we have eye drops at home.
But did they say jolt on them?
I mean, they're pre-jolt, but they are Roto branded. Mm. Which means they're just 5 years older. But they didn't appear to have an expiry date on them, so choice. Yeah, I'm pretty sure that was Corey, Sarah, and I found in my experience best not to get them mixed up. Heather and Corey.
I have some thoughts about how people call me other names, and I'm not going to share them because I feel like I might just sound like I'm being mean.
Mm.
But I like it when people call me by my name. And don't confuse me with other people.
Yeah.
And I understand that sometimes it's a mistake, which is why I also don't want to, like, call anyone out, but...
Just as long as no one calls you mom, right?
I will injure you.
I mean, TBH, I would do the same. Well, no, I'd be confused first.
There's a lot more chickens here. It's raining chickens.
Oh, yeah.
It's raining hens.
Hallelujah!
Got there.
Is this mode a hindrance, says everyone?
I can't tell. It sounds like that pun might just be all bok.
Oh, and no bite. I found it excellent. Oh, I'm so excited, Heather. I managed to remember this time before coming here to put some chicken breasts in not just to thaw, but also to marinate in a brine solution. So those chicken breasts are going to be so juicy in tonight's curry.
Right, you said you were making an Indian curry, right?
Yes. But I find that any time I forget to brine my chicken, it ends up being a little bit drier than I'd like. Mm. But whenever I brine it, it's just salty, juicy, and succulent all the way through. My recommendation is 2 tablespoons of granulated salt per, I think it's 2.5 cups of water. Oh no, sorry, per liter, yes. Woo!
Reminds me, I gotta poke Beach about us replacing our microwave.
Ooh.
Stopped working.
Oh no.
Like, I put food in it, I heated it up, I left the room to go do something because it's gonna take a couple minutes. It made the sound that's like, things are ready, and I came back and it just stopped working.
Huh.
It was no longer working.
That's no good.
And it's not like we use the microwave a ton, but it's nice to not have to like heat up the oven to heat up your food a lot of the time.
Thankfully, microwaves are pretty inexpensive.
Yeah, we just have to actually go and acquire one.
They're also really good right now.
We're thinking one can actually attach the bottom of the cabinet so that we can get some of our health space back.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
No, that's not Jesus.
No. That's interesting, because that's actually the exact opposite of what I want. I've got one of those under or over the stove microwaves that also acts as a fan. And I want it gone.
Mm. We have a range hood over our oven that just blows the air out in front of it.
Yeah, those are the worst.
Which is about each is eye height.
Oh,
each
good.
Is eye height.
So smoke directly in eyes.
Yeah,
so
we don't use it. It's useless.
But I really look forward to when I move out of the place I'm in, because it means I'll be able to buy a new microwave.
Mm. And yours came with your place?
Well, it's, yeah. And on top of that, the microwave I brought from Edmonton is currently here at the moon base.
Mmm.
And I've been wanting to get rid of that microwave. Because I bought it just before microwaves got really good and cheap. I want an inductor.
This song is just... really suits what's going on screen.
Yep.
It's just like, you're fighting some chickens. There's four of this guy hanging out having his own party. It's raining chickens. See, this I don't mind. Like, a little bit of, like, the notes having a thing happen. A little bit of a distraction thing with, like, an overlay. I don't mind. The warping of the screen with weird technicolors and things flashing.
Not cool for
is,
Heather.
It's kind of just a bit much. I can't imagine it's... And I don't typically have problems with too much of that stuff, so I can't only imagine that what kind of hell that is for those who do.
I can't imagine what these would be like with hard mode on.
Yeah, I don't really want to know that.
Is he doing a different dance in each one of the quadrants?
Yes.
Good.
Just said he's having a party. Exactly what my house parties are like, except less moving, sitting on a couch, watching Netflix, and I'm fully clothed. So nothing like that at all.
I was gonna say, so you're fully clothed?
Yes. Well, and the TV. I make everything wear clothes.
Okay.
This is my party. I get to do what I want.
It's true. You did go to school for putting people in clothing.
Yes, I did.
Yes. But not televisions.
Well, you gotta branch out.
I mean, you know, as you know, that we are experts in the fact that televisions can wear clothing. Go back and watch our Persona 3 dancing in bullshit streams.
Persona 4. I don't want to be that person, but I'm going to be that person. It's Persona 4.
You're going to correct the Persona 3 to 4, but not the dancing in bullshit parts.
Well, no, because it was dancing in bullshit.
Ah, yes, good. That part is at least accurate.
But 4 is the one that has the TV.
Okay. I'm going to go back and save this for us. Because I think it's time for us to end today's stream.
Yes. Also, good. The Persona 4 dancing one was one of our best streams.
No. Yeah.
And it's not even in the Rhythm Cafe section, because it's in Rhythm Tuesday.
It is classic, and I think it's one of the reasons why we're still doing this show. We're chasing that dragon's tail. Hey, guys. Thanks for joining us today here on Rhythm Cafe. I had a lot of fun.
Me too.
Good. That's all that matters. I hope you did too, but you know.
If you also had fun, that's great.
Yeah. You know who else had fun? Or at least I'm making an assumption here based on their actions. I'm going to say Joseph Death had fun because they resubscribed after 63 months.
VM Kid also probably had fun for 53 months. Hello, my name is Ian Horner, and dubs are a perfectly valid way to watch anime, Beach Face.
Oh, look at how that didn't happen for my mouth. It's Mo Christ Hagdrum, Mox Hagdrum, subscribing for 21 months. Button sent me, loading ready run, please.
To host okay. 01, 30 months, welcome back.
Duck! Lazna, subscribing after 3 months. Thank you so much for joining us.
Beware the pickle for 27 months and not for any more months until next month.
302 underscore Dave, subscribe for 18 months. Thank you for your continued support.
Earth in One with that 101 bits. Thanks for the chill stream. Always chase the perfect golden voice.
Of course. And Lanthus has been here for 31 months and thank you for continuing on into your 32nd. That's it for our subscribers. If you like subscribing, but you don't like Twitch, you can head on over to patreon.com/loadingreadyrun. Beach has many many slogans for them that I'm not going to repeat here.
It's a website.
It is a website. Patreon.com. It's a website. Of course, thanks to all of you who do subscribe here at twitch.tv. Those of you who chose to sub here or sub at other ones, or those who just lurk or chat, whatever. Thanks for watching and being here with us. What else we got to do here?
If you're watching this on Twitch, which is right now because we're live, then you will find these VODs over at youtube.com/loadingreadylive. If you are watching this as a VOD, which means it's not currently live, we stream these over on twitch.tv/loadingreadyrun.
Back and forth forever. Check the schedule over at Loading Ready Ride.
Loading Ready Ride, not affiliated.
No, not even a thing. Loadingreadyrun.com/live. That'll show you when we'll be streaming here in the future, both Heather and I and other people. But for people who don't want to watch you here anymore, Heather, where can people find you?
Don't want to watch me here?
I mean, who want to watch you elsewhere other than here, maybe?
Oh, okay. As long as you're sticking around here, yes, it's please. Like the cafe has to stay so open somehow. Mm-hmm. You can find me over at twitch.tv/lunarjade. I'm also lunarjade on Twitter, and Ian, you also do a thing somewhere else?
That's right. You can find everything I do, both on Twitter, on Twitch, and what have you, at tilty.house. That's tilty.house. Put it in your browser and go nuts. Donuts.
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 Donuts. That's from an anime, I think.
Yeah. Cool. I can't. Go nuts, that's it. Thanks so much, everyone, for joining us. We will see you next week for more Rhythm Cafe. Do go away, but then come back.
Enjoy your life. Have fun. Do something. Goodbye. Leaving.